What's up, Zombie Slayers? This is KJ48, and welcome back to my 7 Days to Die single player Let's Play. This is episode 23, and today we are going to be starting to prepare against this 7-day horde, which is actually going to be day 21. I am making some gunpowder, trying to get my gunsmithing up as high as possible. If it's not up to 100 by the time the 7-day horde comes, 21-day horde comes, I'm going to put points into it because I want to repair my guns. Today we are going to be working on defenses for our base, which is going to include extra log spikes, barbed wire, and we're also going to need wood and iron, which I forgot to bring up. Actually, I don't think we have a lot of wood here, but that is okay. As you can tell in the bottom left-hand side, I did hurt my leg when I was climbing down that ladder. You know how I jumped down it, whenever I come down? Well, I jumped down it the other day and I didn't stop. So, yeah, I broke my leg. So, I had to fix my leg and now I'm walking down the ladder. What are you going to do, right? All right, so let's start boosting this place up. We got to get ready for the 21-day horde. For those of you who are new to the game, I just want you to know that the 21-day horde is the first real horde you're going to face. The day 7 horde and the day, 14 horde were just a warm-up. This is the real horde. This is the beginning of the real hordes. You're going to be facing spitter cops that spit acid. You are going to be facing ferals, which have 2,800 hit points. It's no joke. It's no joke. So let me just quickly make a little way back into my base. And then we will get ready. We're gonna put some extra spikes around us. A little bit extra defense. We do have a shotgun for the horde. And I do have a Magnum as well, which is honestly the only... Well, it's not the only gun that I like, but it's my favorite gun. And, yeah, so we've got a lot of deer. I should probably kill some of these guys. Got him. Finally. do I have room for this? I do have room for this. So, let's cut them up. Remember, use your knife on the animals, guys. For the three new players, you know. And, we're gonna carve this guy up real good. I've not been doing a ton of hunting, although I should. Because I'm gonna need more forages and I'm gonna need more food as well. So, I did see another deer over there somewhere. I'm not gonna worry about him right now. I don't want the meat on me because it smells. But, honestly, I don't think it's gonna be that big of a deal. But I do need inventory room, so I'll drop it off over here near the farm. Anytime you have meat on you that smells, it's going to attract zombies in the area. Although the area that it attracts them in is not overly large, but still. There's not much point in leaving it there, right? Alright, so... Okay. So here we go. We will start doing this base over here. It's time to break this thing up. This guy's been here long enough. There's nothing in there I care about. I did it like day one. Time for him to go bye-bye. Alright, so we're going to have to put down some more spikes. Now what we're going to do is we're going to put some spikes. And we're going to put them behind the spikes we already have. In front of the spikes we already have. Now, the thing about spikes is the zombies will just run through spikes. So if a zombie's going to run through spikes, it's not going to have that much of an effect on the zombie. Because they're just going to run through it. That's where the barbed wire comes in. I think the barbed wire hurts the zombies, although I'm not sure. I'm pretty sure it does. But what it really does is it slows them down, and it's going to cause them to walk over the spikes very slowly while taking damage. So what we're going to do is we're going to put the barbed wire on these spikes first of all. Alright, so let's go ahead and do that. It's going to make it really hard to repair them, so... Although, it doesn't make it impossible to repair them. Someone was telling me trenches are not... Actually, a lot of people were against the whole trench idea. One person came up with the idea that the fact that you're going to put down a trench really doesn't help you. It's kind of like, you know, a waste of time. And I agree. It is a waste of time. Trenches really don't do much for you. They do a little bit for you, but they're not really worth it, in my opinion. I'm just doing it because it's something different for you guys. So, just be aware of that. I'm also deciding on how far I want to dig for this area right here, but let's not worry about that right now. Let's get these down. Also, I'm going to make, well, let's finish up with some more gunpowder here, and then when that's done, I'm gonna make what are they called, poles, concrete poles, and we'll make 8 of those. Okay, So you put them on the bottom and you put them on the top, like so. And what this is going to do is when the zombies run up to you on Horde Night and they're running, this is going to stop them in their tracks. It's going to really slow them down. And it's just going to give you a little bit more time to get some pot shots in. You know, the barbed wire will eventually break away. It's not great. I mean, it's helpful. It's really helpful. And it gives us something that this game sorely needs, and that is more traps. The biggest downside of this game is I don't feel like there's enough traps. That's just my own personal opinion. All right, so I think I want 3 full spots in between these. I think that should be pretty good. Although I could go with 2. The thing is, if I walk in between these to repair, you could get stuck on that pretty easily. I think 3 is good. Let's just leave it there. So we're going to put 1 layer of spikes. And again, I need to decide when to start digging here. Oh, it's pushing it down. That's pretty cool. Should I start digging? Yeah, let's dig. Digging's easy. Okay. And then what we'll do is we'll put some of these down to push this down. Oh, okay, so that one can't be pushed down. That one actually has to get dug. It's hard to tell which one you're supposed to dig and which one you're not, you know? There we go. And put you down, flatten that out a little bit. Okay. Beautiful. All right, let's upgrade these. You never want to leave spikes down unupgraded because they're extremely weak. You know what? I don't have a lot of wood for this. I completely forgot. We do have some trees in the area to cut down, though, so it shouldn't be too much of a problem. You never want to leave these spikes down unupgraded, because when they're unupgraded, they are really, really, really weak. So, yeah, do yourself a favor and upgrade them right away. Because if a stray zombie, even like one regular zombie, comes walking through here, they could, like, wreck one of these spikes pretty easily. And then you just wasted your time. Okay. So let's punch out some more grass. We're gonna need some room. We are gonna need some room. Let's hit our drop-off chest by the farm and make some room, because we're simply got too much stuff on us. What can I drop? Let's drop that. We don't need those. The thing is, once I put stuff in these chests, I freaking forget about them. That's what I hate the most. And it's nobody's fault but my own. I mean, you know, I got no one to blame, but I still don't like it. All right. Okay, looking good, looking good. The hell was that? That was a zombie. It just broke its legs on my spikes. There you are. I heard you. Okay. Alright, so let's continue working, shall we? Alright, so this is going to come out all the way through here. Dig this out. Hey man, why not? It's easy to dig out now, right? Now, I don't really want to dig all this out because that's starting to get to be a bit much. So now what we're going to do is we're going to start letting these come up a little bit. And it's okay because it looks okay because of the way that's like kind of like a slope. So I don't mind. Like, and it'll work. It'll be effective, so. Where my axe, yo? How you like these blue tools, huh? How you like me now? Okay, now these I'm not going to have to pull out at all. So this is going to come 3 out. So what was it? 3? 3 full blocks, right? 1, 2, 3. It was on the 4th block. 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. Okay. That's okay. I can live with that. I can live with that. If this is my main base, I'd probably dig out all that dirt, but it's not my main base. I fully expect for day 35 to be done at my main base. I think we're probably going to be here for day 21 and 28. Alright, this is bothering me. Somebody said to use the stone axe on the corpses. The problem is I never have a stone axe on me, and I don't want to keep a stone axe just for that. All right, it's good enough. Let's upgrade these. Actually, we're not using a ton of wood on these, so that's pretty cool. All right, upgrade time, baby. You know what? I think it's time for a time lapse. We haven't done it, or build lapse. We haven't done a build lapse in quite a while. So enjoy the build lapse. Okay, guys, welcome back. Oh, we got a screamer. Crap. How do I want to handle this? I think I'm just going to hang here for a minute, see what happens. She's right on the other side of this tree. I don't know if you saw her. She's heading this way. Oh, I can hear her. Shit. She's gonna scream. I'm just going to wait until she's right next to me. Where'd she freaking go? Oh, there she is. She's milling around out there. All right, we got to get her. Let's block her with this rock. She's looking for the forge. What she's really looking for is the source of the heat in the area. Let's get her. Oh, missed. Wow. She did not want to die. I deserve the horde on that. That was my fault. My bad. All right, let's go ahead and make a spike club here. A better spike club. And then we're going to scrap this one. You could use this heat thing to farm zombies if you want. The problem is it could call more of them, so we gotta be careful. Let's just cut down that tree. Is that spike club done yet? Yep. Oh man, I'm so close to making blue weapons. I gotta get some blue weapons going for sure. But tonight I'm gonna work on tools. Oh, there's another one. Okay, did she scream? Because it sounded like she did her scream, but I don't think she screamed, guys, because she didn't turn around and come at me. She doesn't scream unless she sees me or senses me. I don't think she sensed me. Plus, I don't see a horde. Oh, really? Ooh, military fiber. Alright, I don't think she called a horde. Alright, let's continue. I'd like to get more wood, but you know what? I think we gotta keep doing what we're doing. I'll get wood off camera. We're gonna have to start planting some trees, too. I haven't planted a trees in a while. That's a problem, actually. But I want to plant them by my other base, you know? Plus, I think I have a lot of wood at my other base. It's always good to get your construction skill up, people. I play on a multiplayer server, and even if you play on a multiplayer server, you need to get your construction skill up. You need to get all your skills up. You might not want to specialize in those skills, and that's fine, but you still need to level them because they will level your character. So it's important. All right, what am I doing here? We don't need that. Let's grab that and put it right here. Okay. All right. Let's go ahead and repair all these. We could probably repair these and upgrade them from the inside. As a matter of fact, I know we can, but whatever. It's easier from out here. All right. Oops. Careful, cage. Jesus. All right. Let's get down the barbed wire on the spikes on the outside first. Those mean more to me. So let's do this. And like I said, the zombies are going to run into this barbed wire, and they're just going to... It's just going to stop them. And during a horde, they're going to break them eventually. But still, you know, every second counts. And it really helps. I really like these things. And the thing is, it's not so much that they stop them. It's that they slow them down, allowing them to take extra damage on the spikes. Alright, you might be wondering why I made these concrete poles. These concrete poles serve they don't do anything for you. But I like them because they look cool. And they do actually you do actually have to sacrifice a little bit of barbed wire to do them, because you can't put a barbed wire here on the bottom. But I don't care. They look freaking cool. Barbed wire needs something at the ends to hold it up. It just doesn't stay up on its own. So I can't put one down there. Hold on. We'll take care of that. There we go. Alright. And put some here for the double. There we go. Those aren't exactly lined up, but you won't be able to tell, so it's fine. This side, right? Yeah, so it means it goes right here. Wait a minute, why didn't I just do that? Why didn't I just do that? Cage, come on, man. Get your head out of your ass. Basically, what's going on with these poles is they're taking up a whole block, but I put this pole in the wrong corner. If I put it on the right corner, then it would be a lot easier to... then I could put the barbed wire down. I'll show you what I mean. Alright, so what I did was I put the pole right there, which means you see that green outline? It's occupying that square, and that square is where I would normally put the barbed wire. But if you put it here, it goes in the corner. You'll see. There it goes. It goes in the corner, and you can still put down the barbed wire on all sides. So you still get the cool look, and you're not wasting any spots for barbed wire. So that's the way you want to do it. Put it on the very corner. And again, if you don't want to deal with these poles, you don't have to. It's just for looks. But I don't know, man. Like, looks mean a lot to me, obviously. If you're watching my Let's Plays, you'll know. So, I care. I care what this stuff looks like. I'm going to need a lot more barbed wire, aren't I? All right, tonight we got to get some barbed wire. Which means we're going to need more forged iron. We could probably make it right now, actually. Let's just make it right now. And the cool thing about this defense is, as the days go on, you can keep putting more and more barbed wire. I don't know what to call these. What would I call this outer defense? The row of spikes with the barbed wire behind it. We need to name it. What does it do? Well, it slows down / stops the zombies, giving you more time. So it's kind of like a time thing. It's not really going to decimate them, but, you know, it gives you more time to act. We'll try and think of a name for this. For this outer line defense. I would like to name it, because I think it's worth a name, because it's a really cool defense. That's got to go down. That's got to go down. This has got to be dug out a little bit. I don't want the zombies jumping over the spikes. Although with the barbed wire there, they're not going to be able to jump over the spikes, but still, it'll just make it a little bit easier. Let's get this over here. And the reason I'm using concrete here is because you can actually upgrade these to reinforced concrete. But you're really wasting resources doing that. But you can if you want to, if you want it to look cool and really last. Okay, so like that. And like that. I might actually dig this out a little bit farther too. Thing is, I need this grass. I need it for my toolsmithing. Okay. And I need to eat. I'm gonna go eat and stuff at night. Screw it. I don't care. I'm not going down just to eat. I'll eat when I go downstairs. I don't have any food on me, do I? Nah. I can drink. Oops. Don't drop it, Cage. I think stuff like tea should give you a little bit of hunger. Because I think tea actually does give you some sustenance. Okay. We'll just leave that one right there for now. And now we gotta put it on the top layer. Basically, what this top layer is resting on, because some people are asking me how to stack barbed wire, this top layer is resting on the spike itself. Like, basically, you kind of like look at the spike, the top of the spike, and that gives you the ability to lay down the barbed wire. If the spike wasn't there, you'd probably still be able to do it, but it'd be a lot harder. I'm standing in the way, so it's supposed to go like this. No? Okay, so right here, this barbed wire right here is taking up this block. So that's why I can't put another barbed wire there. So what you do is you put a barbed wire like this, and it's taking up the block right here. It's not resting on anything. I guess it's resting on the barbed wire underneath it. It's more important to get the barbed wire up on the outside of this build than the inside. So I'm going to keep going with the outside until it's done. And I don't know what we're going to do tomorrow, honestly. I mean, I don't really want to go to my other base tomorrow, but I don't think I'm going to have too much more work to do here. So maybe tomorrow I'll just skip recording the day and I'll just farm. I'll just mine. I'll get some clay. I'll get some wood. And I'll just farm and I won't record it. And then maybe the next... No guarantees, but I'm thinking the next video might be the Horde Night. Damn it. Got too much crap on me. Okay, man, I'm really out of this stuff, huh? Can I put one right there? Yeah, it's fine. It's fine the way it is. Okay, another one that's got to come this way, towards me. Oh. Okay. I must have put this one right here must be occupying the outside, which is fine. Oh, no, it's not. Yeah, whatever. It'll go where it's supposed to go eventually. God damn it. We'll leave that down. You can actually put them behind the spikes as well. That would actually slow them down even more if you want to. You can also put these lying flat on the ground. I choose not to do that. I'm sure it's very effective. But I choose not to do it because I think it kind of looks stupid. Although I might mess around with it on my next defense. Perfect timing. All right, guys, we're gonna call this one here. I have not made up my mind how I'm gonna handle this for tomorrow, but right now I'm leaning towards skipping all of day 21, and you'll come back at the Horde. I'm sure you will not mind. But if you come back at day 21 and I'm still building, then just bear with me. We'll get to the Horde eventually. So that's gonna be it for episode 23. We'll see you next time for episode 24. Until then, take it easy.